Hi fam, how are you doing? Welcome to Monday Moments. Thank you so much for being here. If it's your first time here, you're most welcome. Whether you're new or you're old, returning, you're welcome. You're welcome. It's great to have you. Now, on that note, I've seen that we have a few new subscribers, so let me just say thank you at this point. Thank you so much for joining this channel. I'm sure you're going to have a great time here. Now, what I want to talk to us about today is grief, grieving, you know. For the sake of the guys who are new here, I will mention that I recently lost my mom. She passed on 19th of June, which means in about 2 days, it's going to be the second month. It's going to be 2 months since she passed. And I was reading a certain article which made me think a lot about how grieving is actually a process. And then before I go very far, let me mention that this year, even before we lost mom, there have been so many funerals just in the estate where I live, in the area, because it's rural. The whole like area, that you'll hear of this home, have lost a son, this other place, I don't know, a child did what, someone fell into a dam. All sorts of freak and non-freak type of accidents, but all of them are loss of children. Just recently, about 2 days ago, I lost a bit of a distant cousin. His was very sad, in fact, because he was graduating and he... Yes. Anyway. So, there's been a lot of death this year. It's really crazy, personally, if you ask me, because there's so much. It's almost worse than the time of COVID. There's been a lot of loss of life. My mother just happened to be one of them. So she was in hospital for the new people. She was hospitalized for about 2 weeks, and then she never came home from that. But she was battling colon cancer. She's been in a battle against colon cancer. So I was looking at I was reading a certain article, because sometimes I check up on, you know, how people handle these type of issues. So I read this article by a psychiatrist named Elizabeth Ross that was talking about 5 stages of grief. And it was very enlightening, and I thought it might help someone who's going through something similar to what I am going through, because as I was saying to you earlier, there are a lot of people who are grieving at this point. And the 5 stages are denial, because you don't want to believe, anger, bargaining, depression, and finally acceptance. Acceptance is the last stage, and now you really, you know, agree that this person has gone. So according to the psychiatrist, grieving, first of all, is different for everyone. It's not something standardized. Everyone grieves in a different way. And it's important to understand the process. If you know what takes place, it will be easier to deal with someone if you're the one comforting a grieving person, and it will be easier to understand yourself if you're the one going through the emotions, the grief, and you're not understanding what is happening. Yeah. So in denial, which is the first step, it helps us minimize that pain. The pain that you've actually lost this person, and you're not going to see them again. They're no longer in your life. Maybe you were with them just last week, or you spoke to them on the phone a few days ago. The shock of it and the pain is what makes denial a very powerful tool or emotion in the grieving process, because it allows you to refuse the reality of what happened. And in the process, you're able to absorb slower. It lets you, like, digest, so to speak, this occurrence, this new thing that has devastated your life, right? During this stage, we find our reality has shifted. The way you see things, sorry. I didn't realize I was trying to speak over the plane. So during this time, this period. During this time of denial, your reality has completely shifted. You refuse to accept. You cannot accept. Your mind has just gone somewhere else where you're trying to figure out life without this person, and your head is telling you no. It just doesn't want to accept. So during this period, it's the time when you try to come to terms with, am I really not seeing this person again? Will I not call them on phone? You mean we're not talking again? Such. At this time, you find you have so much information you're trying to process, because you have all these imaginations. You're trying to adjust. You go over conversations. You see the last things you did with this person. All of that information is slowed down by denial. Denial allows you not to process all this at once, and for it not to hit you so hard in a way that your system cannot cope with. So denial is very key in the healing process. So the second stage that you're going to pass through is anger. You're going to be angry. You'll be angry with yourself. You'll feel angry at God. You feel angry at the person who died, because how could they just leave you like that, right? You'll be angry at the world. You'll be angry. Just expect to have feelings of anger generally. You know, this is not the time in your life that you're going to feel very rational. Yeah, so you'll have a lot of emotions that don't make a lot of sense, but that's just how you feel, and that's how it is, right? That's how you feel, period. You see, you're trying to adjust to a new emotional discomfort. And it's not a nice thing. It's not a pleasant feeling. So anger just feels as if it makes things easier to process. You don't have to explain too much. You don't have to try and analyze and understand everything. Anger is a nice cover. It kind of gives you an escape from dealing with all the reality, right? And it feels more socially acceptable than admitting that you're scared. That this situation has thrown you off your feet, you're very lost and you don't know where to begin or what to do, how to accept and deal with all of this. So anger becomes a way to express emotion with less judgment, right? A lot of the time, it's not that you don't want people to come and comfort you, but the anger is the first thing you feel when you realize, as you're starting to accept that, okay, this thing has actually happened. The person has left you and you have this void. Anger just helps you deal. Yeah. So anger is the second thing that you're bound to. The problem now with anger is that it can cause guys to stay off because they don't understand why you're lashing out. And as a result, it makes you feel isolated. It will make you become isolated because if guys can't come to comfort you, you're perceived as unapproachable. So you end up being alone in your grief, which is, again, counterproductive. But that's just one of the stages. If people know and are aware, they know that, yes, okay, after this stage, we'll be able to talk to this person. But if you don't have them, you will wonder, you know, let them stay with their grief after all. Yeah. Yeah. So I think this is information that is useful to know all around. The third stage is bargaining. Now, the loss can cause you to feel so desperate that you try to bargain with life generally to get yourself out of what you're feeling. I don't know if it makes sense. You're trying to ease the pain of what you're going through. So you end up, normally it would be with a higher power. It's you bargaining with God. God, if you let this person get well, I will do this and this, I'll change, I will stop what I was doing, I will not be talking badly, I will stop drinking, you know, those type of things. So that kind of bargaining usually will be now with God, a higher power, because you're trying to see in desperation, can this situation change? Can it just not happen? Is there something I can do that can make this thing not to be real? So this is the stage at which now you realize how helpless you are. You can do nothing about the situation. If someone greater than you, God, doesn't do something, things are thick. It actually comes from a sense of helplessness. And this is the stage where we focus on our own personal faults, our regrets. It makes us look back at what we wish we had done or we could do. You know, that type of thing is what goes on during this stage. You're coming closer now to really accepting how things are. There's quite a bit of regret also in this stage where you start thinking about all the things that you may have done that wronged this person, made them feel bad, and you're wishing, you know, I wish I could get a do-over. This is where you want another chance to right whatever wrongs you feel maybe you made. Like I was saying, it's not the most rational time of your life, so you'll find yourself thinking that if you had not done certain things, if you hadn't talked to them badly, if you haven't done, I don't know what, maybe things wouldn't be the way they are. It's just desperation. It's all part of that stage that you go through as you try to accept the situation. So this is like a last attempt to discuss with God and see if perhaps maybe he can change his mind and give you another chance to relive this life. Yeah. So I can actually remember myself at this stage because I was like telling myself, maybe I should have gone more to the hospital. Should I have done something different when she was here? You know, because when she went to the hospital for the final admission, she was here at my place. And I was thinking all sorts of things. So when I was reading this article, then I realized, oh, okay, so that was this bargaining stage where I was thinking, okay, in fact, I don't even know if mine was bargaining because I actually knew she was coming. The way she left, it's like she was gone before I realized she wasn't coming. So I didn't get so much time to bargain. But the time she was in hospital, because for the 2 weeks she didn't speak, that's the time I started thinking in my head, I should have spoken more to her. Maybe I should have seen her more in her OC or those type of things. But it never occurred to me that she actually might not come home. You know, that one was a shocker because all along I knew she was going to be okay. She did look like she was pretty bad, but it just seemed so surreal. It just didn't look like it was an option. So perhaps that was my denial playing out or my bargaining. I don't know. I was just praying for her to get better and to be able to control her faculties because she started looking like she was not talking, she was not functioning so well. So I was trying to imagine, okay, if she comes home and she still can't move or speak, how am I going to take care of her when I don't know what it is she needs? So my worries were more on that line, not like she actually isn't coming. You know? Once the beginning stage now passes, that's when depression now sets in. Reality hits. You realize, okay, things are not going to change. This is your reality now. And the loss now begins to actually hit you proper. That is when now you begin to get depressed because now you're accepting that this person has actually left your life. This is like the hardest stage. So the panic you were feeling earlier now begins to leave. All that fogginess in your emotions is beginning to subside. It's clearing. Facts now are setting in. Now it's facts. And they're not nice facts. They're not easy. But you've processed a lot of emotion at this point. So where you're at now, you can deal with reality. So at this point, you begin to withdraw more. What had begun as anger now can continue. And you find yourself isolating yourself. You're staying more on your own. You're not socializing much because you're dealing now with inward emotions. Initially, it's like you are lashing out. Now you're faced with what has hit you and your loss, you know, by yourself. You're internalizing everything now. The thing now with depression, it's a normal stage in loss and grieving, but it should not take forever. It should leave after some time. You should be able to snap out of it. And this is where family and friends and having people around you help a lot. Because if you stay on your own too much, it can end up now becoming a full-blown sickness. You know, depression is actually a thing, it's a sickness. And if you're not able to snap out of it on time, it no longer now is just a side effect of grief. It becomes now an actual issue that has to be treated. And finally, the last of the five stages is acceptance. This is not the stage. This is not to mean that you no longer feel the pain of loss, but it's like it has registered that this person has gone. I definitely have not got there yet. I'm still somewhere on one of these other stages. It's only 2 months, as I was telling you guys, so it's going to be a while. But acceptance is now when you can talk about it. It looks like it's a reality now. You know within yourself that this thing has happened. You're, at this point, you're no longer resisting. You know, you're not trying to make things change. You know that it has happened. And I remember when the pastor came to give mom communion in the hospital, he asked us, are you ready to let go? Whoa, no way. Oh, I said, no. Later on, he told us he had felt it. He could see this isn't going to go how we are hoping. He was kind enough not to tell us at that point, but yeah, he asked us, are you guys ready? So acceptance stage now, you've accepted that nothing can change, you know, that this is just how it is. So sadness, regret, these emotions are still very present, even at this stage. It's just that now you're not trying to make things something they're not. And then with each of the stages, there's no like fixed time. It's like an individual just has their own time to deal with it. Each can take however long it takes. There's no fixed like period for them. So I think the thing that is most important here is just to realize that everyone grieves differently. What can take one person a few weeks will take another one several months, and people grieve even for years. So there's no rush. I think everyone just has to heal at their own time, at their own pace. Yeah. So like your pain, you see, your pain is unique to you. You have your own way of feeling your pain. It's your right. It depends on your relationship with the person you had, your own relationship, however your relationship was, will determine your healing process, your pain process, everything, right? So the key thing is to take the time you need to heal as you, without any expectations, without any deadlines or anything on how it should be. No one should be like giving you, you know, timelines. It's a purely personalized process. So I hope you guys found this video useful. If you did, give it a like. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And I will see you next week.